But fortunately for me, we have two very nice people also from India. We were on stage, on different stage today, and accepted to last minute, so it's really not fair for them. I hope you will be gentle to come with us, because we have at 5:52, we are waiting for also another panel, and we wanted also to discuss a bit about India. It was a goal to have Mr. Kapoor here, because I don't know if you are aware, but just India is not anymore an emerging market. I hear many times people speaking of India like that, but it's just a country with more than what? 1.23 billion people? I always forget the number, right?
Yeah, there's a lot of people, yeah.
and it's just a country where last year the government said just overnight, okay, let's say that 87% of the bills you have in your pocket are no more value, and let's begin to work digital and so on. So, and if you add to that 93% of the population has a biometric identity, you just see that contrast compared to where. So I wanted, we have a chat with two really interesting people. I will let them present themselves. You have one expert on fintech, international expert on fintech, specifically working in India, which is Aditya. And you have Yashish, which is a CEO of a very huge fintech. It's not anymore the small guys, but I will let you introduce yourself. Please, Yashish, and then Aditya, introduce yourself.
So I run a company called Policy Bazaar, which essentially does online insurance. And we are more than 50% of the market in India. But I think the two big disruptive things that happened in India, one was November last to last year, when the Prime Minister announced that certain notes were going out of circulation. And that was a large part of the cash that people were holding. There's a large black economy in India. And a lot of people were very challenged. People with truckloads of cash were very challenged. They made a lot of noise.
What exactly happened? I mean, overnight, he said, these bills, no more value.
In fact, we are. What people know is that many people in the cabinet also did not know it was going to be announced. So it kept very, very secret. And I think it was a big move. He was trying to attack corruption in a big way. I think the second big thing that has happened is what you would call biometric authentication. So 93% of Indians have biometric authentication now, and that has all happened within 12 months. It was a big problem, people walking in through porous countries, et cetera, whole lot of issues. Issues stay, but no other country in the world has implemented so quickly at that kind of cost. So the cost of this biometric authentication implementation, which so far is largely tamper-proof, is less than 5p per customer or per Indian. And I think that is that kind of tells you what awaits us in terms of fintech. So I think authentication and payments is largely going to be backstacked by the government and will be available for free for pretty much everybody.
I need to present yourself.
Aditya Kurjekar. I run a company called Medici. Some of you might know us as Let's Talk Payments. And we have been in this world of fintech before it was attractive to call it fintech. So we started the journey with Money 2020 as one of the founders of that, and then we have really focused on giving structure and organization to the world of fintech, right? We have taken a lot of effort to develop the taxonomy for fintech globally, and we cover innovations and innovators, 11,000 of them on the platform now, all over the world. India is a particular focus for us, and for a couple of reasons, right? I think like Yashish said, the government has taken an initiative to invest in the infrastructure that allows the standard of innovation to be higher for everybody.